Boswell Media Sports.
Welcome in, Whippet fans, to another edition of Kosciuszko Whippet Baseball here from Boswell Media Sports. Breck Riley with you today. As you can tell, this is not Philip Palmetry. Philip is on another assignment today, another broadcast. It's that time of year. So, hey, let me dust off the headset for the first time since November. We're glad that you've joined us for Rivalry Baseball. It's the Louisville Wildcats coming down to take on the Kosciuszko Whippets. And if you're wondering, that's a little earlier than usual. Well, that's right, because you got some rain moving into the area here a little bit later this evening. So the ball game was moved up from 7 o'clock to 4 o'clock in hopes to get at least some of the game in before it starts raining. Now, they'll play in the rain. Now, it's the storms and the thunder and lightning that they don't like to play in. So hopefully we can get some innings in, if not an entire game. But it'll be rivalry baseball, the first of two games between these rivals this week today. And then on Thursday, Kosciuszko will make the return trip over to Louisville. And we came on air just a little bit early because I believe we're going to have a special treat for you. Of course, you may be listening on Breezy 101 or the Breezy 101 app or BreezyNews.com. You can go to the Boswell Media YouTube channel or BreezyNews.com to get the live video feed. And that is brought to you by Pickles Drugstore. But we're going to have a special treat for you. So we came on the air just a little bit early as we get ready for a first pitch, a special first pitch coming up here in just a few minutes. So while we get ready for that, we will remind you that we do have another broadcast coming up, two more broadcasts coming up this week, Thursday, and then on Saturday as Ridgeland comes to town. But Walker Hill will come out to the mound to throw the first pitch, and we'll try to get some camera work going on for you here. Of course, he was the starting center fielder for the Whippets, injured in a car accident back in October, and he is going to throw out the first pitch for the Whippets today. He's a three-year letter winner, would have been, or he still is, the team's captain. So Walker, you ready to throw out the first pitch here at the ballpark between the Whippets and the Wildcats? He's got to warm up just a little bit. And he gets a pretty good one. There it was. Walker Hill throwing out the ceremonial first pitch for the game this afternoon. So he'll get the ball back from today's starting pitcher, Nolan Yule, and we'll get ready for our Wendy's pregame show. But yeah, thanks for having us on. It's the Whippets and the Wildcats. Wildcats coming in at 0-9 on the season, and Whippets at 6-4, 3-0 in division play, region 4-4 play. We do have starting lineups for the Louisville Wildcats. We'll run them down for you. We don't have classes, what grades these young men are in, but we do have positions and everything else. Jace Hudspeth bats first, plays shortstop. Batting second will be the left fielder, Jaden Triplett. Batting third, playing second base, will be Isaiah Harden. Nick Jackson bats fourth, plays third base. Caleb Hughes
bats fifth and catches. Nigel Anderson will play first base, and he'll bat in the sixth spot. Arion Johnson will play center field and bat seventh. Braylon Kincaid on the mound tonight for the Wildcats. He bats eighth. Caleb Ball is the designated hitter. And Jakevious Gauls will play in the field at right field, but will not be in the batting order. That's right. And the Wildcats are running out to take their spots along the first base dugout as the starting lineups are being called out. And we will get to your Kosciuszko Whippets. Kalen Powell leads things off for the Whippets. He plays center field. It'll be Larson Fancher in the second spot, handling DH duties tonight. Connor Wallace bats third, plays shortstop. Ethan Wood playing right field, batting cleanup. Nolan Yule on the bump tonight for the Whippets. He bats fifth. Parker Riles moves over to the hot corner at third base. He'll bat fifth. Riley Patton plays first, bat seventh. Ty Remage, the eighth grader's behind the plate. Will Carter will play left field, and it will be Landon Wallace playing second base, but not in the batting lineup. So Powell, Fancher, Connor Wallace, Ethan Wood, Nolan Yule, Parker Riles, Riley Patton, Ty Remage, Will Carter, and Landon Wallace. The lineup for the Kosciuszko Whippets. And we're just a few minutes away from first pitch. I know they're trying to roll really quickly here, so we have a really quick Wendy's pregame show for you because of that. They want to get the game in as quickly as possible. We should let you know that the Kosciuszko Lady Whippets softball team playing a doubleheader over here just to our right, Northeast Lauderdale at 5 o'clock, and then I believe League Central coming up at 6:45. Hopefully they can get those ball games in before any rain or storms get here. But we will step aside for our national anthem and our prayer.
Tomorrow starts today with Wendy's breakfast. A tomorrow that says bacon, not bacant. Where fresh eggs reign like opportunity. Honey butter goodness is spread. And the frosty is chinoed. At Wendy's, we don't ask what tomorrow holds, but rather, what will you hold tomorrow? Will it be the breakfast baconator or the honey butter chicken biscuit? No matter what you choose, tomorrow's looking good.
At participating U.S. Wendy's.
Hey, I'm Ryder Davis with Farm Bureau. As a young insurance agent, it hasn't taken me long to understand the value of life insurance. Even at an early age, life is unpredictable, and it is important that your life is properly insured. With age and good health, there is never a better time to get life insurance than when you're young. Whether you're married or living on your own, someone you love is responsible for you. Life is not guaranteed, but our life insurance is. Call me, text me, or come see me today at Farm Bureau on the square in Kosciuszko.
You can now bank closer to home at Itala County Bank.
Hi, this is David Blair with Itala County Bank. I have been serving the people of Itala County with commercial, mortgage, and personal loans for 25 years. Please come see me at Itala County Bank. I look forward to serving you.
Itala County Bank, in the North Side Shopping Center next to Sullivan's in Kosciuszko. Call 290-6963. Hometown banking in your hometown. Member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender. Still serving the people of Holmes and Carroll counties. Itala County Bank, a branch of Holmes County Bank.
The beauty of spring starts at the Itala County Co-op. From your lawn to your flower beds, the Itala County Co-op will make it stand out against the rest with fountain, outdoor furniture, plants, and yard art. It's t-shirt weather, and the Itala County Co-op has a large selection of Old Row, Southern Point, and Strut and Cotton t-shirts, and new spring apparel from Ariat and Carhartt. For the perfect drinking experience, grab a brewmate before you head out to the baseball or softball field. The Itala County Co-op, Highway 12 East in Kosciuszko.
Boswell Media Sports.
And we are back here at the Itala County Fairgrounds, Whippets Stadium, for Kosciuszko versus Louisville, the first of two games this week in a region 4-4A showdown. On the mound this afternoon for the Whippets will be Nolan Yule on the season 5-2, 13 innings pitched. He has struck out 21, given up 10 earned runs, walked 17. So he'll get the start tonight. Talk to Coach Boland just before broadcast. You know, normally we get Parker Riles on the Tuesday night ball game, but Coach said maybe you want to rest him up just a little bit as the Whippets get ready down the stretch for Northeast Lauderdale and West Lauderdale. So kind of rest up there. Number one starter there, maybe get him a little healthy, but he's still in the field today. He's over playing on that hot corner at third base, so he's still going to be in the lineup. The Whippets are coached by the second-year head coach, Derek Bolin, which, I mean, it might as well end up being a first year because, you know, last year they didn't get but a few games in before the season has ended because of the pandemic. So hopefully Whippets are able to get in a full season this year. The Wildcats, coached by Nick Morrow, Nicholas Morrow, not to be confused with Vic Morrow, if I remember correctly, was in the TV show Combat, Twilight Zone movie, among a few others. Throw down to second base in the warm-ups, and Whippet infield will come in and gather around the man, Holman Yule. Just ready for baseball. First up for the Wildcats will be the shortstop, Jace Hudspeth. You might know that name. He plays a little quarterback for the Louisville Wildcat football team, who was the 4A state champion this year. I recognize a number of these names on the roster. First pitch swinging. Strike one. Didn't connect. Good stuff there from Yule. First pitch comes at 3:59. A little muggy out at the ballpark today, about 77 here at first pitch. There's the delivery, a little high, kind of leaving up at a ball and strike. Field conditions and weather report brought to you by Itala County Farm Bureau. You know, just underway here between Kosciuszko and Louisville. That one went ran a little high. On Yule again, two balls and one strike. We don't have any stats on the Louisville Wildcats. Those were not made available to us before the game, so we're just going to have to go with what we got here. Now Yule's into his windup. Caught the corner with that one for strike two. Two balls, two strikes to count. It was a big weekend for the Whippets. They played two games in one day. On Saturday, we'll tell you more about how those games went as we go along. 2-2 pitch coming. A little low, scooped up by Remage. Count runs full to the leadoff batter, Jace Hudspeth. Jaden Triplett, the Wildcat left fielder, standing in the on-deck circle. Payoff pitch coming. It bounces to the plate. Hudspeth draws a leadoff walk. We'll bring in Jaden Triplett, left fielder. As we said pregame, we don't have any classifications. I'm not sure what grade these young men are in. We'll see if we can get that as the game goes along. What a leadoff walk for the Wildcats as runner on first base. He will work from the stretch now. Triplett shows bunt. Left it out there but couldn't connect. Didn't really try all that hard to connect with it, but he did leave it out there. Well, it might be sort of the bunt and run. But Hudspeth didn't go. He didn't have too big of a lead, but the count's 0-1. There's a breaking ball, comes back over the corner for a strike. It's a good look at pitch there from Yule. Quickly, 0-2 count to Triplett. And a slight breeze blowing at the ballpark today. Was going to look Hudspeth back at first. Well, he comes set. Swinging strike three. And he is out. First strikeout of the game for Yule. The pitch was dropped behind home plate, but matters not. First base was occupied, so runner could not run. That'll bring up Isaiah Harden. Isaiah Harden is the second baseman for the Wildcats today. Another one of those Wildcats that also plays on the football team. Quick throw to first. Patton gets Hudspeth back, but he's in under the tag. Yule just keeping him honest over at first base. First inning play, no score between Kosciuszko and Louisville at the home ballpark today. He shows bunt. must have been a little low and off the plate. Not a bad looking pitch there from Yule. I think you might have hoped that Harden would have taken a stab at it on that bunt, but he did not. Infield back at double play depth. The brothers Wallace right up the middle. That fastball stays a little high on Yule. Count will be 2 balls and no strikes. Yule looking for a sign. I will check the run over at first. Comes to the plate. That one's a little low. Ball three. 3 balls, no strikes to count. Isaiah Harden. Nick Jackson, the third baseman, had come to the plate. That one's right down Main Street for a strike. 3-1 goes the count. It's an odd game here. Not many folks in the stands just because, 4 o'clock first pitch, many people still at work. That ball runs low on Yule, and it'll be a walk. Jackson will come to the plate. Wildcats have runners on first and second with a one out, and Nick Jackson. Baseman, Wildcats in their road crimson uniforms, white numerals, white helmets with cats written across the chest there.
Pitch bounces to the plate.
Ball one. Whippets going with their maroon tops with the white KHS stripe across the chest and the white trousers. There's a swinging strike one. Yule brought a little heat on that one. So kind of leaving up at a ball and a strike. Yeah, what we're saying is not many people here at the ballpark, so it's a little quiet. It's kind of an eerie feeling. Their ball is hit through the gap right past the first baseman. Wood's going to come up with it. They'll hold the runner at third base. But that one was just a little dribbler right past Patton. That'll be a single, and the Wildcats will have them loaded for the catcher, Caleb Hughes. Patton was playing a little close to the bag there, not necessarily holding the runner on, but, playing a little close to the bag. And that allowed the dribbler to eke through the infield. Wildcats have ducks on the pond with only one out. And Hughes fools him on a breaking pitch and a great stop by Ty Ramage to keep that one in front of him. That one bounced. Hughes had no idea where it was going. Oh, and won the count. That one catches the corner for strike two. Shadot Yule still working from the stretch, even though the bases are all loaded. Pitchers prefer to do that. Yule taking his time getting a signal from his catcher. Now he has what he wants. That one runs just off the plate just a little bit for ball one. He wanted that same spot on that last call before that, but he ran just a little outside on it. Bases are loaded for the Wildcats. There's another breaking ball that bounces and a good stop by Ty Ramage. We got Jace Hudspeth standing down at third base. You figure with him being the leadoff batter, he's probably got a little bit of speed to him. Anything gets by Ramage, he's probably going to be trucking it for home. 2-2 pitch. It's hit to Patton. He'll step on first, take the fielder's choice. One run will come in to score. The Whippets do have two down in the inning now. So Wildcats go up.
Now batting number 18, Nigel.
1-0. The runners advance to second and third as Nigel Anderson comes to the plate. Wildcat first baseman, the first lefty that will walk to the batter's box. He swings over the top of a fastball, can't connect, strike one. Hmm. First innings for Whippet Baseball brought to you by the Itala County Co-op. Ramage sets up. Scoops up another one. That was a little low. Ran a little low on Yule. 1-1 the count. To Nigel Anderson. That's a high fly ball. A couple of Whippets going back, and Powell calls them all off and makes the catch, but not before the Wildcats push one across. Played half an inning. Wildcats lead it 1-0. We're back after this here on Boswell Media Sports.
Renaissance Insurance is your neighborhood insurance partner. Renaissance Insurance makes you feel at home with your home insurance. When you hit the road, Renaissance Insurance makes sure it's with the right auto coverage tailored for you. Renaissance Insurance takes the hassle out of sorting through business insurance. One stop, complete coverage. Call Robbie Robertson, Bradley Tyler, or Michael Hatcher at 662-289-4621. Renaissance Insurance, Court Square, Kosciuszko.
Premier Medical Group and Trace Urgent Care remind you that if you have any COVID-19 symptoms, please call first. There are multiple options to see you. Also, talk to your provider about your wellness or healthy you appointment. This appointment is covered by most insurances, and it will help you maintain your health and prevent illnesses like cardiovascular disease and certain cancers. Premier Medical Group in Kosciuszko and Carthage, and Trace Urgent Care. Call for an appointment today.
Boswell Media Sports.
Due up for the Whippets here in the home half of the first inning will be Kaelin Powell, Larson Fancher, and Connor Wallace. The Wildcats pushed one run across there in the top of the first inning, which was not something they've been able to do very often. In their past six games, they've only scored one run. Five out of the six, they've been shut out. They were able to get one run against West Lauderdale in the second of that two-game series. The Wildcats able to push one across. Whippets hoping they can answer back. On the mound for the Wildcats will be Braylon Kincaid. Once again, don't have much on these Wildcats other than starting lineup, basically. But it is Braylon Kincaid, and he has the task of facing off against Kaelin Powell, who is, as George Jones would say, hotter than a $2 pistol lately. He's batting .594 in the game against Pearl this weekend. He had all four of Kosciuszko's hits. He went 4-for-4, had a home run, scored both the runs in that 4-2 loss. So if you're a pitcher, you don't want to see number 11 walk to the plate. But he will dig in and await a pitch from Kincaid. 1-0 your score. Kincaid toes the rubber. He'll go into his windup. That one's high. Came in a little inside. Almost. If Powell had been leaning over a little bit, that one would have got him. But good patience there from the Whippet center fielder. That one's hit about a mile in the air. Catcher's going to come back and try to give way and make chase. Cannot get it. Hughes played it right off the circle there where the grass meets the back of the batter's box, and it kind of ran back a little bit on him. So kind of leaving up at one ball and one strike. Kincaid will dig in and work to Powell. That one's low inside for ball two. Yeah, 594. That's what you want out of your leadoff batter if you are Coach Derek Boland in these Whippets. And that one's hit high. I think it's going to get out of play. It does. It lands over there down the third base line by the Whippet batting cage, if you will. And split a couple of the Whippet fans, maybe a few parents that have able to leave work early and come to the ballpark today. I imagine we'll fill in a little bit once the bell rings for 5 o'clock. Folks are able to get out here. 2-2 pitch coming from Kincaid. That one's just off the plate for ball three. Not a bad-looking pitch there from Kincaid. That's one of those that's kind of been a hit-or-miss call for the pitcher here. Early goings from the man behind the plate. Payoff pitch coming to Powell. It's high, ball four. So both teams able to draw a leadoff walk to start the game. The Wildcats are able to get their leadoff walk all the way around and score. Let's see if Whippets can do the same. Larson Fancher will come to the plate. He bats from the left side. He is a Whippet designated hitter in the game this afternoon. He's batting at 261 on the season. Quick throw over to first. Powell back in plenty of time. Yeah, Powell's dead. You know, the threat on the base paths as well. So if you don't get him out, he's a threat to run. So we told you, stolen base against Pearl. He's going here. And pitch was outside. I don't think it would have been good enough, even if the catcher had made the play, to throw down and get Powell. So he makes second standing up. Hughes not able to corral it. But I did hear one of the coaches say, don't even throw it. Hold it. Inside corner called strike one. And a good-looking pitch there from Kincaid. Whippets trail at 1-0. We are in the bottom half of the first inning. Kincaid looks the runner back at second, but nobody holding him on. That one ran inside on Fancher. He turned it into the first base dugout. Fouls it off. About the same spot where that called strike was on the pitch prior. This time, Fancher pulls the trigger, but only able to chop it over into the first base dugout. Kincaid ahead in the count, 1-2. Kincaid looks back at Powell. There's a pop-up. Hughes looking for it behind home plate, not able to make the catch. It was right up against the netting. Would have been a hard play for Hughes to make. But, yeah, it was right against that backstop. So he would have had to run and try not to run into that brick walkway and then fight the net. So he was not able to give too much of a chase for it. Count will remain at 1-2 to the Whippet designated hitter, Larson Fancher. Kincaid comes set. That one's way outside. It's like a breaking pitch that didn't really break all that much. Well, kind of leaving up at 2-2. And you can tell that rain's about to come in. It's getting very, very muggy and humid here at the ballpark. Wind has pretty much stopped blowing as well. Another pitch outside for ball three. Count goes full to Larson Fancher. Let's have a runner on second base. I love a base hit, but you'd take a free pass if it's given to you. Kincaid gonna fake and run Powell back at second base. He didn't throw it. He just took his foot off the rubber and kind of went through the motion. Now he looks and is going to come to home. And Fancher takes first base while Powell takes third base on the passed ball. More so a wild pitch than anything, but it was ball three. So Powell is able to get, ball four, and Powell is able to get over the third base. Connor Wallace come to the plate. He's the Whippet shortstop. Whippets have runners on the corners. Still nobody out here in the bottom of the first. Inside corner for called strike one. You don't blame Wallace for taking there. Kincaid had thrown 4 balls in a row. That one's high and outside. Ball one. Fancher over first base. Not getting too big of a lead, but you think the Whippets might try to send him at some point with Powell over third now. Kincaid steps off the rubber. Wallace will step out and step back in. The pitch is inside for ball two. That one just been just a little too far inside. Not too bad. My view was blocked with a complete look at the pitch by the home plate umpire and the catcher. And that breaking ball breaks right into the shoulder blade of Hunter Wallace. So Whippets have bases loaded, nobody out for Ethan Wood. And that'll draw a visit to the mound from Coach Nick Morrow. Ethan Wood, another one of those Whippets really seeing the ball well right now. He's batting it at 333. Had a big game against Leake Central this Saturday. He went two home runs in that game against Leake Central. So Ethan Wood is going to dig in and hopefully maybe clear the bases for the Whippets. Maybe push a couple of crosses. They trail it here 1-0 in the home half of the first inning. Ethan Wood also pitched a great game against the Pearl Pirates, only giving up two hits in that 4-2 loss. Striking out 11, but he's playing right field today. He swings over the top of that one. It was like a little bit of an off-speed pitch there from Kincaid. And Wood over the top of it. 0-1 the count. That one's rocketed right back into center field. Catch made. And if it's not able to tag up, I thought Powell might be able to come home on that one. But it was sharply hit. Johnson came in and made the catch. You think with Powell's speed, he could probably leg that one out. But if it's didn't send him, bring Nolan Yule to the plate. Well, Yule batting at 324 on the season. He sends one down the line at third. They're going to try to go home, and it's off the catcher. Powell comes in to score. Jackson tried to get the lead runner, but Hughes not able to scoop it up. We'll roll that one. Error on the catcher for the fielder's choice. Whippets able to tie the ball game at 1-1 as Parker Ryle steps to the plate. Pitch is high. Hughes catches it, but it gets away from him. Nobody running on the play. The bases are still loaded. Parker Ryle's batting it at 308 on the season. That one caught the corner for called strike one. Kind of leaving up at a ball and a strike. Kincaid into his windup. That one hits him between the numbers. Whippets will get another run home. And they'll lead it 2-1. A second hit by pitch of the inning. Still only one down. Riley Patton comes to the plate as we get a courtesy runner. Cooper Black coming in to run for pitcher Nolan Yule out at second base. Patton steps into the left side of the plate. Patton batting it at 250. One's ball one. Sort of inside, maybe a little bit low. Patton really gets up on the plate there. That one's going to get past catcher Hughes and coming around to score is Connor Wallace on the pass ball. Most of the runners are both able to advance their bases. So Black will go to third. Riles goes to second. And Riley Patton faces a 2-0 count. That one's outside for ball three. Three balls, no strikes to count. To the Whippet first baseman. That's Whippets lead it 3-1. Here in the bottom half of the first inning. Taken all the way was Patton, and he draws a walk. That will bring up Ty Remage, and it also brings up a visit to the mound from Coach Nicholas Morrow. He's going to walk in. We're going to have a pitching change. We'll tell you more about that when we come back. Whippets lead it 3-1. Pitching change timeout. We're back after this.
Did you know gum disease is one of the leading causes of tooth loss in adults? Hello, this is Dr. Adam Middleton from Autumn Ridge Dental in Kosciuszko. Studies have linked untreated gum disease to some more serious health problems such as heart disease. Autumn Ridge Dental understands the importance of keeping not only our patients' teeth healthy, but their gums as well. If you are overdue for a dental checkup, call Autumn Ridge Dental for an appointment with one of our registered dental hygienists, and we will give you something to smile about.
Boswell Media Sports.
We come back to the Itala County Fairgrounds at Whippet Stadium, and a new pitcher in the ball game for the Louisville Wildcats will be the third baseman. Nick Jackson walks over from third base. He'll take a few warm-up pitches, and Kincaid will walk over to third base, and looks like they're just going to swap right there. Did not see any other defensive changes for the Wildcats. So due up for the Whippets will be Ty Remage, the catcher. Whippets do have bases loaded, only one out with a 3-1 lead. Whippets undefeated in region 4-4A play. Two wins against League Central. One win over Choctaw Central. The second game there rained out, scheduled to be made up later in April. And the Whippets have two games against the Wildcats today. Will not play Friday. Playing on Thursday. It's Good Friday. So that Friday matchup moved to Thursday. So we have a Tuesday-Thursday matchup for you. And that game scheduled to be here for you right here on Breezy 101. And then Saturday, Whippets will host Ridgeland, a 5A program coming here. A good opportunity for the Whippets. It looks like Jackson is ready to go, and he'll face off against Ty Remage. Remage batted at 226 on the season. That first pitch to Remage runs up a little high fastball out of the zone. Dead air here at the ballpark right now. No wind blowing. Another ball, the pitch is high for ball two. Yeah, the rain expected to move in here. Looking at the weather app, about a 60-70% chance at 6 o'clock. And the coaches are hoping they can get that in, the game in before that. There's a pop over into foul territory beyond the first base dugout. It stayed in play. Anderson gave chase, but not able to come down with it. I think he might have lost it. But yeah, he gave chase. It was still in the ballpark. Hit just beyond the brick wall in front of the first base dugout. But unless it goes down as a strike, so two balls, one strike count. Pitch coming. Bounce and gets away from Hughes. Black's going to come around to score, and everybody else moves up a base. So Black representing Nolan Yule comes in to score on the pass ball. Whippets will have runners on second and third. Still only one out. Ty Ramage at the plate. 3-1 pitch coming. That one's called strike on the outside corner. Man behind the plate's really been generous with those corners here in the early goings of today's ball game. Whippets lead it 4-1. Bounces away, or bounces, but Hughes able to block it up. However, it's ball four, and Remage goes to first base. Looks like Whippets will bring in Eli Kemp to run for the catcher, Ty Remage. Will Carter, the number nine hitter in the lineup, steps to the plate. He's batting it at 267. Carter playing left field for Whippets. The Whippets have him loaded. That pitch is high, ball one. Whippets lead at 4-1. Still do not have a hit in the inning. A long fly ball by Ethan Wood is the only out. Hitting shallow center field. That's ball two to Will Carter. Not too much out of the zone there from Jackson. Didn't catch the eye of the umpire. That one's low, ball three. What do you think, Carter taking all the way here with Jackson having some location troubles. That one's able to find pay dirt for strike one called against Will Carter. First innings for Whippet Baseball are presented by the Itala County Co-op. That bounces to the plate, and another run will come in. And the Whippets have batted around as they take the 5-1 lead. We'll go back to the top of the order with Kalen Powell. Kalen Powell walked to start this inning, came around to score. That ball bounces off of Hughes, but Patton's not able to go anywhere. And the throw back to the catcher, the pitcher gets away from Jackson. Whippets aren't running on that one. Rolled over to first base. Anderson able to get it back in. Oh, Whippets have them loaded. So we're still only one out in the inning. That one hits Powell in the back. It's kind of nicked him just a little bit. And Whippets plate another run. As Patton comes around to score. And Powell will go to first on the hit by pitch. As Larson Fancher comes to the plate. Pitch high and outside, ball one. Whippets have plated six runs so far on no hits. Fancher also walked his first at bat and came around to score. That one's a little high. Ball two. Coming into the ball game, the Wildcats had given up quite a few runs. Trying to get you their past few games. That one's going to get away from the catcher as Carter comes around to score. or that's Kemp running for Ramage, excuse me. Comes around to score. Everybody else advances a base. As the count goes to 3 balls and no strikes. Fancher digs into the left side of the plate. That one's a called strike. Just caught a little bit of the corner. Just ever so smidge of the corner for a 3-1 count. That one's high and inside for ball four. Fancher walks. Whippets have them loaded again. And we're going to have another pitching change. It looks like we're going to have a lot to unpack here, so we'll see what we can do. But Whippets lead it 7-1. We're still in the home half of the first inning. We'll be back after this on Boswell Media Sports.
Change, so does Sullivan's Drugs and Gifts, with all new spring shoes, clothing, and accessories. New at Sullivan's is spring transitional clothing for men and women, and the best selection of ladies' footwear. Revamp your home for spring with colorful home decor and spring candles. Getting married? If so, be sure to register at Sullivan's, where they have most everything for kitchen and home. Sullivan's Drugs and Gifts, Highway 12 in Kosciuszko.
Did you know gum disease is one of the leading causes of tooth loss in adults? Hello, this is Dr. Adam Middleton from Autumn Ridge Dental in Kosciuszko. Studies have linked untreated gum disease to some more serious health problems such as heart disease. Autumn Ridge Dental understands the importance of keeping not only our patients' teeth healthy, but their gums as well. If you are overdue for a dental checkup, call Autumn Ridge Dental for an appointment with one of our registered dental hygienists, and we will give you something to smile about.
Boswell Media Sports.
Back here at Whippet Ballpark, and another pitching change for the Wildcats. Arian Johnson is going to come in from center field to pitch for the Wildcats. And if I had it right, they're not standing at their positions just yet. It looked like Nick Jackson went to second base, and then it seemed as if Isaiah Harden moved out to center field. So we'll have to make sure we get that correct on our sheets here. As Johnson takes his warm-up tosses, they're not all standing at their position, so we'll tell you that. But what we will tell you is that the Whippets lead at 7-1 here over the rival Louisville Wildcats, and they don't even have a hit in the ball game. They have one Whippet has put the ball in play. That was Ethan Wood. He hit a fly out to shallow center field. It was Johnson caught, and that was for the first out. And he's actually on deck right now. Ethan Wood's about to come back around to him. So it'll be Connor Wallace stepping in. That will be the first batter that Johnson will face. Arian Johnson. As I said, Whippets lead at 7-0, still in 7-1, excuse me, still in the first inning. First innings for Whippet Baseball are brought to you by the Itala County Co-op. Once softball starts over here to our right, we'll get you some scores for that one. The Whippet softball team is set to play a doubleheader. Hopefully they can get the game in before any bad weather or rain gets here. That's why this game has been moved up to 4 o'clock. Northeast Lauderdale at 5 and Leake Central at 6:45. So we'll try to follow those games for you. As we said, when they get started. Arian Johnson being in on the mound for the Wildcats. If you weren't here, just joining us pregame, Walker Hill threw out the first pitch for the Kosciuszko Whippets. Of course, would have been a senior on the ball club, was set to be the starting center fielder, probably the leadoff batter, but you know, injured in that car accident back in October. Confined to a wheelchair at the moment, but he came out here, threw a great pitch, good strike. We got the video. We'll get it online for you here post game, so you can see that. But Walker Hill, good to see him back out here at the field. And Johnson's gonna reach down, rub some dirt on his hand as Connor Wallace digs in. Wallace, like many of the Whippets, reached last time. Earlier in the inning, he was hit by a pitch. He came around to score. First pitch from Johnson is high outside, ball one. Bases are loaded. Carter on third, Powell on second, and Fancher on first. That pitch catches the outside corner for a strike. Yeah, umpire really likes that corner call. 1-1 goes the count to Connor Wallace. That one just off the corner for ball two. Yeah, these pitchers, you're getting that corner call. Keep working it. Keep trying to paint it. Oh. 2-1. Pitch just a little high. Not a bad-looking pitch there from Wallace, but maybe just a little high. Kind of go to 3-1. Let's see if the Whippets give Wallace the green light here. He's got the speed on the bases. They will not. It wouldn't matter because it was way outside. And that will drive in another run. Carter comes around to score. Powell moves to third base. Fancher moves to second. Hunter Wallace draws the walk. Whippets go up 8-1. And Ethan Wood comes to the plate. Ethan, the only Whippet to put the ball in play so far here on the afternoon. He flew out to center field. Pitch outside, ball one. Ethan hitting it at 333 coming into the ball game. Arion Johnson, the third pitcher the Wildcats have used here in the inning. It's a breaking pitch that stayed up a little high on Johnson. Two balls, no strikes, the count to the Whippet right fielder, Ethan Wood. Multiple home run game on Saturday, against League Central. Johnson comes to the plate. Ball gets away from Hughes. Powell will come in to score very easily, and the other runners advance up. Whippets lead it 9-1. Still in the first inning. Three of the count to Ethan Wood. That one catches the corner for strike one. Of course, Wood going to be taken all the way there with the location troubles Johnson seems to be having so far. First base now open. There's on second and third. Ball four. Wood draws the one out walk, and they're loaded again for Owen Yule. Yule reached on an error his last at bat. I had been saying that Wood was the only one to put the ball in play. I just do stand corrected. Yule grounded it to third base. The third baseman tried to come home. The bases were loaded, but catcher Hughes couldn't handle the throw. There's another ball. It gets past Hughes. Whippet's not going to try to advance the runners on that one. One and oh the count to Nolan Yule. Hopefully he's staying warm somehow when he's not at the plate. One's off the plate for ball two, yeah. I don't see if anybody's been pitching anywhere else for the Whippets, but you got to think Yule's arm's getting a little cold. He's been here. They're going on about 30 minutes here in this first inning. There's a strike call on the outside corner. 2-1 pitch coming from Johnson. That one's hit into center field. It'll fall in for a base hit. One run will come across. And coming in is another run for the Whippets. So Nolan Yule helping his calls there with a 2-RBI single. As the Whippets take the lead 11-1. Ethan Wood stopped at second base there. But yeah, that was a good hit ball just right over the middle of the infield. Whippets are moving on the pitch. Able to get two runs across. And I believe we have Cooper Black coming in to run for Olin Ewell over at first base as Parker Ryle steps in. Pitches inside for a ball, gets away from Hughes, and the runners will advance to third and to second. Riles was hit by a pitch his last at bat. The curveball hit him right in the back between the shoulder blades. Ethan Wood advances to third. Yule, or I should say Black, running for Yule, advances to second. That one's going to get away from Hughes, but no one able to come back. It hit the backstop and rolled right back to him. So Wood thought about coming home and runs back to third base. So it'll be two balls, no strikes to count. As Johnson goes into his unique delivery. That one's off the plate for ball three. Yeah, Johnson has a unique delivery. I'm not exactly sure what I would call it. He's got his right foot on the rubber, and his left foot kind of stays way off to the side. Oh, that one comes back across the inner half of the plate for strike one. The three balls, one strike. The count to Parker Riles. Riles came into the game batting at 308. That's low ball four. And he draws a walk as Riley Patton comes to the plate. And we're going to have another pitching change. So we'll take another break. Whippets lead at 11-1. We're still in the bottom half of the first inning. We're back after this on Boswell Media Sports.
Vehicle maintenance is often a hassle and occurs at the most inconvenient times. Central Tire Service enjoys vehicle maintenance and focuses on getting you back on the road, from brakes, alignments, and exhaust to oil changes or new and used tires for your vehicle or ATV. Central Tire Service stocks all the major brands, Kenda, Toyo, Firestone, and Goodyear. They specialize in accessories for your truck or ATV and install rough country lift kits. Central Tire Service, across from Louvel on Highway 35 in Kosciuszko.
Hey, I'm James Smetters with Farm Bureau Insurance. For the past 6 years, I've been blessed to serve our community as a local insurance agent. When most people think of insurance, they think of their home and auto, which is the natural thing to do. This year, I'm shifting my focus to what's important, family. Protecting your family with life insurance is the most important insurance decision you will ever make. I'd like the opportunity to sit down with you and your family to discuss your life insurance. Together, we can build a plan that fits your needs and your budget. After all, life insurance is more than a policy. It's a promise to take care of the ones you love, no matter what. Give me a call, 289-4862.
Your pharmacist is more than someone who fills your prescriptions. Your pharmacist helps you understand what medications you're taking. Your pharmacist makes sure your insurance is filed correctly. And your pharmacist answers any other questions you may have regarding your medications.
Hi, I'm Rob Pickle, registered pharmacist and owner of Pickle's Drugstore. It is my goal to give you the personal attention you need to improve your health and well-being. My staff and I are here to serve you.
Pickle's Drugstore, your hometown pharmacy, on the east side of the square in Kosciuszko.
When it comes to insurance, one size does not fit all. At Alpha, the Chris Coleman Agency in Kosciuszko, knowing the customer and their individual needs is what we pride ourselves on. We know how important it is for everyone to have the peace of mind that your insurance coverages are tailored for you. Our team recognizes your life and your unique needs. That is why we provide you with numerous insurance options, an easy claim process, and personal attention that is second to none, all at one location without breaking the bank. Call us today at 662-289-1024 or visit us at 235 North Madison Street off the square in Kosciuszko. At Alpha, the Chris Coleman Agency, we guarantee the right fit for you and all of your insurance needs.
Boswell Media Sports.
We come back to the Tyler County Fairgrounds. Pitching change number four for the Louisville Wildcats. It's Nigel Anderson coming in from first base. Now, he is a lefty. It'll be the first lefty that's come in. He'll face Riley Patton. Whippets have an 11-1 lead here in the home half of the first. There were some defensive changes. We'll get you those after this first pitch. Anderson to Patton. Pitch ran high. Ball one. I do believe, if I saw correctly, that Arion Johnson went back to center field, and then Isaiah Harden came to play first base. We'll have to get that corrected on our list here, but I believe that's what it looks like. A little breaking pitch hung up on him for ball two. Bases loaded here for Kosciuszko. It's Riley Patton, lefty-on-lefty matchup here. Facing Nigel Anderson. He swings. He can't connect at that one. What a bad-looking pitch there from Anderson. 50 minutes, or, yeah, exactly 50 minutes in to the first inning. They're still here. That one hit over the back of Patton. I thought that it hit him, but Patton says it did not. I thought the umpire awarded him first base. I think Patton doesn't want to be hit by the pitch. I think he wants a chance to hit. So either way, it's 3-1 to count now. He swings over the top of that one. For strike two. Oh, I guess they're saying that that other pitch hit, it was a foul ball and it hit his bat. So that was what he was pointing at rather than that he got hit by a pitch. So there's a second out of the inning as Ty Ramage comes to the plate. Ramage walked and scored back in the, or we're still in the first inning. His earlier at bat in this inning, he walked and scored. Bases loaded for Ramage. He hits that one as a little chopper to third. Kincaid comes up with it, throws it across in time to make the play. But the Whippets push across 11 runs on one hit. There were plenty of errors and three men left on base. We'll be back after 60 seconds on Boswell Media Sports.
From the classroom to the athletic playing field, Holmes Community College provides a world of opportunities. A first-class education, affordable tuition, and accessible locations make Holmes your best choice to further your higher education. Holmes Community College is consistently recognized as one of the best community colleges in the state of Mississippi. Let Holmes Community College fill your needs by providing classes for academic transfer, learning a new trade, or improving your skills through a workforce development department. For more information, log on to the school's website at holmescc.edu or calling 1-800-HOLMES-4.
Boswell Media Sports.
After 52 minutes of play, we finally advanced to the second inning. Whippets lead it 11-1 over the rival Louisville Wildcats. Nolan Yule will come back out to the mound. It's a good thing he was finding a way to stay warm over there. I don't know if they got him an electric blanket or something, but, I mean, he was over there for, as we said, about 45 minutes just sitting and hanging out rather than when he was coming in and batting. But he'll go for the Whippets here in the second inning. Second innings for Whippet Baseball are presented by Renaissance Insurance. Due up for the Wildcats will be 7, 8, and 9 in the batting order. Arion Johnson, Braylon Kincaid, and Caleb Ball. Starting to cloud up a little bit here at the ballpark. So, you know, we are expecting some rain. So number four will step in, and on our list, we have four as Jameer Jones. So we'll have to get that correct. Pitch from Yule is in there for a strike. As we told you earlier, not a lot available on this Louisville Wildcat team, so got about four different rosters we have to look over before we can get the right number. That breaking pitch didn't break the way you wanted it. It'll be one ball, one strike to count. Whippets lead at 11-1. That pitch high, ball two. As we said, clouding up here at the ballpark. Weather report brought to you by Itala County Farm Bureau. Still getting humid outside. That pitch low, I guess. Looked good to me. Three balls, one strike to count to Jameer Jones. According to this roster, he is a sophomore. Second baseman, that pitch finds its mark for strike two. Oh, you will into his windup. High and outside for ball four for the second straight inning. The Wildcats are able to draw a leadoff walk. Coming up now, it's Braylon Kincaid. Started the game on the mound. I believe he's playing third base right now. I'm not 100% certain with all the defensive shifts that we've had, but I believe he's at third base. There's the pitch. Catches the corner for strike one. Bottom of the order, the nine-hole hitter, Caleb Ball, on deck for the Wildcats. There's a chopper. It's hit to Wallace at second. He'll flip it to his brother for one. Throw it over for two. The brothers Wallace turn the double play, the 4-6-3. And only two outs in the inning. We do have a new player in the ball game. Swings over the top of it for strike one.
Now batting number 14, Hakeem Holman.
One catches the corner for strike two. This is Hakeem Holman, who's coming to the ball game. So a lot of defensive and offensive changes for the Wildcats. That pitch is high over the head of Holman for ball one. One ball, two strikes, the count. Pitch bounces in the dirt, gets away from Remenshoff to the side for two balls and two strikes, the count to Holman. Two pitch coming, swinging strike three, and that retires the side. No runs on, no hits, no errors, nobody left on base. Whippets lead it 11-1. We go to the bottom of the second inning here on Boswell Media Sports.
You've changed thousands of diapers, played peek-a-boo and duck-duck-goose for hours.
Yep.
Because you do anything for your kids. That's why it's so important to protect them with life insurance from State Farm.
Yep.
State Farm agent Angel Albin McDonald will help make it easy and affordable to help protect your family no matter what the future holds.
That's
because
right.
For the people you do anything for, life insurance can mean everything. Call State Farm agent Angel Albin McDonald in Kosciuszko, Mississippi today. Like
good
a good
day.
Neighbor, State Farm is there.
662-289-3 161.
Y'all have a good one now.
Are you tired of being turned down by the other guy?
Turned down for what?
Come to Lindsay's Auto Sales, because we will not turn you down for credit here.
Turned down for what?
Lindsay's Auto Sales, Low Down Payments and Low Monthly Note, Kosciuszko and Ackerman.
Boswell Media Sports.
Nigel Anderson comes back out to the mound for the Wildcats here in the bottom of the second inning. Whippets have a 10-run lead, 11-1. Due up for the Whippets here in the bottom half of the second inning would be Will Carter, Kalen Powell, and Larson Fancher. So the number nine hitter will come to the plate. We'll get back to the top of the order. The Wildcats have used six guys on the mound. If you're just now joining us, maybe you're getting off work and tuning in as you drive out here to the ball field, wanting to catch a little baseball and then softball. It'll be a good night for it, as long as the rain holds off, which we expect to get some here shortly. But Anderson will dig in and work against Will Carter, and his first pitch is high for ball one. Will Carter walked and came around to score back in the first inning. A long first inning that the Whippets had. Off-speed pitch is off the plate for ball two. Will Carter came into the ball game batting 267. It's the left fielder for the Whippets. He also handles kicking duties for the Whippet football team. That one catches corner, called strike one. He really, really likes that corner call, does the umpire. Anderson into his windup. Carter with a little excuse me swing. I'm not entirely sure he went around, but it was a strike anyway because it's right there on that outside corner of the plate. 2-2 the count. I hear the national anthem being played over at the softball field, so Whippets getting ready to take on the Northeast Lauderdale Trojans in softball action right behind us. That one scooped into left field. One hopper gets it. Does triplet and throws it back in, but a leadoff single for Will Carter as the Whippets get back to the top of the order. Kalen Powell coming to the plate. So far the hottest hitter on the Whippet team. Has been walked and hit by a pitch. You know these guys want to try to get something in play. Anderson will work from the stretch now. Pitch outside for ball one. So Will Carter standing at first base is being held on by Isaiah Harden, who is that new first baseman in the ball game. There's an off-speed pitch that's still off the plate. Two balls, no strikes to count. Whippets lead it 11-1. We're in the second inning, bottom of the second inning. Second innings for Whippet Baseball, brought to you by Renaissance Insurance. Anderson going to step off the mound now. Take a little time. Look back, Will Carter over at first base. Now he toes the rubber. Goes to the plate. High ball three. Three balls, no strikes to count. The Whippet leadoff man, Kalen Powell. As we told you earlier in the broadcast, Powell with a big, big game against Pearl on Saturday. Whippets had four hits in the game against Pearl. Powell had all four of them. One of them was a home run. Pitch off the plate. Ball four. Powell draws a walk. Whippets have runners on first and second as Larson Fancher comes to the plate. Fincher walked twice in the ball game this afternoon, came around to score both times. Lefty versus lefty matchup here. It's a second one of the ball game. That one high over the head of Fancher. Well, Fancher, tall kid there. So for that one to get over the top of him, pretty wild pitch. That one is outside, but Carter able to take second base, or throw down not in time, throw down not in time. So Powell takes second base. More stolen bases for Kosciuszko. Stolen bases brought to you by Lindsay's Auto Sales. As now first base is open. 2-0 the count to Fancher. Runners on second and third. Fancher swings over the top of that one. Can't connect. Two balls, one strike. Whippets ahead 11-1. If you're just now tuning in. That one comes in and hits Fancher right between the numbers on the back. So he's hit by pitch. He'll take first base, and Connor Wallace comes to the plate. Wallace is hit by a pitch in the first, and he walked in the first, came around to score both times. That pitch is high, ball one. Base is loaded for Connor Wallace, the Whippet Jr. Swings over the top of that one. Count will even up at a ball and strike. And Connor Wallace's favorite baseball player is Derek Jeter, the captain. Who doesn't love Derek Jeter? And being a shortstop, you know, it's got to be a good role model to look up to. The pitch is high. Ball two. 2-1 the count to the Whippet shortstop, Connor Wallace. Two one pitch, swung on, hit into left center field. That one's going to roll all the way to the fence, probably going to clear the bases. As Wallace will stop at second, and they will stop Fancher at third. But a double for Connor Wallace drives in two more runs.
Now, banker with number 16, Ethan Wood.
And Ethan Wood comes to the plate. With lead at 13-1. Ethan Wood in the ball game is 0-for-1. He flew out his first at bat in the first inning, and then he walked in the second at bat in the first inning. That time he swings over the top of it. Sounded like he might have got a piece of it, but nonetheless, it's a strike either way. Whippets 13-1, leading it here in the bottom of the second inning against the Louisville Wildcats. That one's hit sharply down the line. It's a fair ball. Fancher's going to come around to score. And Wood stops at second base. Wallace also comes in. Back-to-back doubles for the Whippets. And they have a 15-1 lead. Boy, that was the reason they called third base the hot corner. Kincaid able to almost get his glove on it, but it was a hot shot. Well, that'll bring up the pitcher, Nolan Yule. Prior to this inning, Yule had the only hit in the ball game for the Whippets. He put the ball in play twice. That one gets past the catcher. Ethan Wood will take third base. Yeah, Ewell's put the ball in play twice. He grounded into a fielder's choice in his first at bat in the first inning. The third baseman threw it home and got away from the catcher, and then he had a single, his second at bat in the first inning. So Ewell seeing the ball well. Anderson still dealing. Now he'll step off the mound. There's the pitch to Ewell. He wanted to swing, but he was able to hold up on it. But it goes down as a strike. He must have caught the inside corner. That one's going to get past the catcher, rolls to the backstop, but Wood's going to stay at third base. Umpets aren't trying to run up the score or anything here, not sending anybody home on that one. Two and one the count. And that one's hit off the glove of Kincaid at third base. And Wood will come around to score. We'll give him a single.
Now, probably
could be ruled an error. Wasn't exactly a routine play, but Kincaid did have to move a little bit to his left to try to get to it. So we'll give him a single on that one. Parker Riles will come to the plate. Whippets lead at 16-1 now. Parker Riles. First pitch, strike one. Riles in the game was hit by a pitch and walked. Pitch is called strike two. On the outside corner, 0-2 the count to Parker Riles. That one's hit deep down the left field line, drifting foul. That one would have been a homer over the 305 sign in foul pole in left field, but went just a little foul. Hit the top of the Whippet football locker room. Oh, Riles gave it a ride. This counts as a long strike. One ball, two strikes. That one's hit to shortstop. Hudspeth going to flip it to second base for one, and they're not able to get the flip over to first. But grounding into the fielder's choice. One down in the inning as Riley Patton comes to the plate. Patton in the game, 0-1, walked and scored in the first and also struck out in the first. 16-1, your score. Whippets leading it, breaking pitch comes back across the plate for strike one. Nigel Anderson still dealing it on the mound for the Wildcats. Patton swings, can't connect to that one. According to Patton, he is a world-class, world champion ping pong player. Self-proclaimed. Bounces past Hughes, and they're not going to run Riles. They're going to leave him at first base. One ball, two strikes to count. But yeah, we'll have to talk to Patton. Maybe we get him and ask him about his ping pong playing prowess. Of course, you may know the name Patton. You're a fan of Mississippi State baseball. That one's hit high in the left center field. Coming in to make the catch is Johnson for out number two. He had to cover some ground to make that now, catch, but they're two down in the inning. Now I see that that is Jameer Jones in center field and not Johnson. There's been so many defensive changes that we're not exactly able to keep up with them. But well, it's number four. We're not 100% sure number four is Jameer Jones, but that's what we're going to go with. And first pitch coming inside to Ty Ramage is a little inside for ball one. There's a little chopper to Kincaid at third. Plays it off his hips, but not able to come up and make the play. So Ramage reaches on the error. Well, Kincaid's being picked on over there at third base. Eh? That'll go down as the E5. As we have a pinch hitter in the ball game to get my, looks like Hayden Rogers is gonna come in and bat for Will Carter. So we'll make that note as Eli Kemp comes in to run for the catcher, Ty Ramage. So Hayden Rogers, the junior, getting his first at bat today. I'm trying to find you some stats on him if we can. -16 your score. Whippets is the commanding lead here in the second inning. Roger swings, can't connect at that one. Count will even up at one ball, one strike. He's batting in the place of Will Carter, who started this inning off. That one rolls past Hughes for ball two. Hayden Rogers here on my stat sheet comes in batting it at 400 in five at-bats on the season. Well, if my math is correct, that means he's got two hits. I'm not great at math, but I know that one. That pitch is high. It'll be ball three. Runners on first and second for the Whippets. Rogers pinch hitting for Will Carter, facing a 3-1 count. And Rogers thought he had a first base, but called strike on the outside corner. Not a close ball game. I don't think anyone's going to argue with that one too much. The count will go full. Runners will be moving on the pitch here. Full count with two outs. And that one's lined in the center field. Jones going back over his head. And it'll die in the dirt at the track. They'll stop at second base. Rogers coming in with the pinch hit double. And Riles comes around to score.
Now batting for the Whippets, number four, Cooper Black.
And now we're going to have another substitute. Cooper Black will come in and bat in place of Kalen Powell. Black's been in the game running for Nolan Ewell as a courtesy runner. That pitch high, ball one. If my stats are to be believed, this is the first at bat of the season for Cooper Black. Normally used as a pinch runner. He can't connect on that one. -17 Whippets leading it here. Second inning. high and outside ball too. Runners on second and third for the Whippets. Pitch low. Pitch is on low and inside for strike two. So, 2-2 the count. I think that one was just sort of a gift from the umpire, which, once again, not many people at the ballpark going to complain too much. That was hit, rocketed into right center field. Drive in one run. Rogers comes in. Got a new player coming into the game. Landon Wallace, I mean, he's already in the game, but he's going to bat in place of Larson Fancher. So Black gets the single and stops at first base. And Rogers stops at third. There's one swung on, a diving attempt, throwing it last second. And Wallace is able to beat out the throw as the run comes home. That'll go down as an infield single. Good play by the Wildcats second baseman, Nick Jackson. He had to run very far, make a diving stop, and did a good job just to flip it over to first base to attempt the play. But Wallace able to leg out the infield single as Rogers comes around to score, and Black stops at second base. I have a new player in the game that I'm 100% sure I have on a roster. Looks like Drew Grace coming into play. At bat for Connor Wallace. Trying to get all these names in while we can. Young men getting the ball game. Deserve to have their name mentioned on the radio. Go down in the stat book. That pitch is low for ball two. Two balls, one strike to count. To Drew Grace, batting for Connor Wallace. Pitch is high. Ball three. Looks like the rain's starting to fall here at the ball field just a little bit. Nothing too crazy, but no storms or anything just yet. And Grace takes a stab at that one, catches it off the handle, and rolls foul towards the first base dugout. But, yeah. And some rain starting to fall, just a little drizzle. Nothing too crazy. Payoff pitch. High ball four. Grace draws a two-out walk. And
now batting for the Whippets, 29, Braylon Albritton.
Braylon Albritton will come in for Ethan Wood. And bat. Just some info on Albritton. He's a junior. Pitch low and inside. Ball one. Albritton. Don't have any at bats for Albritton on the season either. We are going to have a pitching change. Whippets lead at 19-1. And we'll step aside for a few minutes and come back, get you the info on the pitcher. Whippets up 19-1. We're back after this on Boswell Media Sports.
Renaissance Insurance is your neighborhood insurance partner.
Renaissance Insurance makes you feel at home with your home insurance. When you hit the road, Renaissance Insurance makes sure it's with the right auto coverage tailored for you. Renaissance Insurance takes the hassle out of sorting through business insurance. One stop, complete coverage. Call Robbie Robertson, Bradley Tyler, or Michael Hatcher at 662-289-4621. Renaissance Insurance, Court Square, Kosciuszko.
Premier Medical Group and Trace Urgent Care remind you that if you have any COVID-19 symptoms, please call first. There are multiple options to see you. Also, talk to your provider about your wellness or healthy you appointment. This appointment is covered by most insurances, and it will help you maintain your health and prevent illnesses like cardiovascular disease and certain cancers. Premier Medical Group in Kosciuszko and Carthage, and Trace Urgent Care. Call
when the seasons change, so does Sullivan's Drugs and Gifts, with all new spring shoes, clothing, and accessories. New at Sullivan's is spring transitional clothing for men and women, and the best selection of ladies' footwear. Revamp your home for spring with colorful home decor and spring candles. Getting married? If so, be sure to register at Sullivan's where they...
New pitcher in the ball game for the Wildcats, Isaiah Harden. That will be pitcher number 5 from what I have on my list. He'll face Braylon Allbritton. And that will be a called strike one. There was already one ball in the count when he came in. I did not see the defensive changes for the Wildcats. We'll have to get you that when we can. That one's hit right back up the middle, almost hit the pitcher. Allbritton comes up swinging and gets a single and drives in a run.
Now batting with number 19, Eli Ramage.
Looks like number 19 is going to come in. That will be Eli Ramage to bat in place of Nolan Yule. Called strike one. Try to once again try to get you some stats when we can. Whippet using a lot of guys that might not have been used in the lineup. That one's hit into shallow right field. Right fielder coming on, making the catch, and that will retire the inning. But the Whippets get 9. No. Yeah, they get 9 on 6 hits, plenty of errors, 3 men left on base. Whippets lead at 20-1. We're back after 60 seconds on Boswell Media Sports.
Vehicle maintenance is often a hassle and occurs at the most inconvenient times. Central Tire Service enjoys vehicle maintenance and focuses on getting you back on the road, from brakes, alignments, and exhaust to oil changes or new and used tires for your vehicle or ATV. Central Tire Service stocks all the major brands, Kenda, Toyo, Firestone, and Goodyear. They specialize in accessories for your truck or ATV and install rough country lift kits. Central Tire Service, across from Louvelle on Highway 35 in Kosciuszko.
Hey, I'm James Matters with Farm Bureau Insurance. For the past 6 years, I've been blessed to serve our community as a local insurance agent. When most people think of insurance, they think of their home and auto, which is the natural thing to do. This year, I'm shifting my focus to what's important, family. Protecting your family with life insurance is the most important insurance decision you will ever make. I'd like the opportunity to sit down with you and your family to discuss your life insurance. Together, we can build a plan that fits your needs and your budget. After all, life insurance is more than a policy.
Did you know gum disease is one of the leading causes of tooth loss in adults? Hello, this is Dr. Adam Middleton from Autumn Ridge Dental in Kosciuszko. Studies have linked untreated gum disease to some more serious health problems such as heart disease. Autumn Ridge Dental understands the importance of keeping not only our patients' teeth healthy, but their gums as well. If you are overdue for a dental checkup, call Autumn Ridge Dental for an appointment with one of our registered dental hygienists, and we will give you something to smile about.
Boswell Media Sports.
Top of the third inning, Kosciuszko leads it 20-1 over the Louisville Wildcats, and a lot of defensive changes. We appreciate the help of the press box crew up here helping me get the defensive changes noted here. Hopefully we got them all correct. The new pitcher in the ballgame will be Eli Ramage. Eli Kemp comes in behind the plate. It's Peyton Odom over at first base.
Now batting
Landon Wallace moves from second base to shortstop. Drew Grace comes to second base. Robert Pickle plays third base. Hayden Rogers in left field. Cooper Black in center field. Braylon Albritton in right field. So I think we got all of those ready to go. And it will be the top of the order due up for the Wildcats. That will be Jace Hudspeth. He scored the only run for the Wildcats on the afternoon. He walked the very first at bat and came around to score. Ramage's first pitch in the dirt for ball one. I'm going to try to get you. We hear a lot of cheering going on over here at the softball field. I'll try to give you some updates on that one if we can find them. We'll get someone to go peek at the scoreboard for us here in a minute. Swinging strike one from Ramage to Hudspeth. Well, we need to get Ramage a hat that fits. Every time he pitches, his hat comes off. I have the exact opposite effect. I don't have many hats that'll fit my head. They all stay on too tight. 1-1 pitch. That one comes back across the pleat for a strike. Ramage with an interesting delivery. He's on sort of not necessarily a sidearm or submarine. You call it maybe a three-quarter delivery. I'm not sure what you call that, but definitely a unique look. And he works from the stretch. That one goes outside for ball two. Okay, only about two balls, two strikes. Yeah, I'll try to get you some pitching stats on Ramage if he's gotten any games so far this year. We'll see what we can find. Hudspeth catches a piece of that one, but it fouls it off his foot, it looked like. He's going to be okay, but get another opportunity. I don't have Ramage with any innings pitched so far. So a lot of young guys getting some good experience here in a varsity matchup. That's a Whippets lead at 20-1 in the third inning of play. Swinging strike three. Great little breaking ball there from Ramage. Strikeouts are brought to you by Holmes Community College. Triplett 0-for-1 in the ball game coming to the plate. He started the game at left field. All the defensive changes, I'm not 100% sure he's still playing left field. He didn't strike out. Swing and strike one. All right. Swing and strike one from Ramage to Triplett. We do have an update for you on the ball game. The softball game, I should note, we'll tell you after this pitch. Breaking ball in the dirt for ball two. Bottom of the second, Kosciuszko softball leads Northeast Lauderdale 3-0. Big division matchup there. Two big division matchups to play Northeast Lauderdale. And if they can get the game in before the rain comes, Leak Central. 1-1 the count. There's a little chopper down the third baseline, or roll foul. So one ball, two strike the count. Whippets up 20-1. This division matchup is looking to remain undefeated in Region 4-4A play. That one's a wild pitch out to the side. Two balls, two strikes, the count to Jaden Triplett. Yeah, a lot of young players getting in the ball game today. Two-one count, and that one bounces. Comes up here eye level with us. So that'll be three balls and one strike to Jaden Triplett. Yeah. That one's hit right back up the middle. Diving attempt just out of the reach of Wallace. Black will get it in. Second hit of the ball game for the Wildcats. That'll bring up Isaiah Harden, who is the pitcher in the ball game at the moment. So far today, I have Harden playing center field, pitching, first base. Runner's going to try to go to second base, and he does take second without a throw. Harden swung and missed. Kemp wasn't able to hold on to the ball. That kind of negated the throw. 0-1 the count as the wind picks up here at the ball field. We've already got reports of rain here throughout Metallic County. Good scoop by Kemp there to keep that one in front of him. Got reports of rain throughout the area, southern part of the county. We do know it's all around us. As I said, the wind's picking up here. That pitch low inside, rolls away from the catcher, Kemp. But the runner will stay at second base. Two balls, one strike. Brand new infield and outfield for the Whippets here in the third inning. The 20-1 lead. And now Harden's going to try to take third. Throw gets away from the third baseman. It bounced down, but Rogers there to back up the throw. It was going to be a hard play to make anyway because Harden, or Triplett, was pretty much halfway there when Kemp decided he was going to try to gun him down. Inside corner called strike two. Count goes full. One's in the dirt for ball four. No, one out walk for Isaiah Harden. Runners on the corners with Nick Jackson coming to the plate. Jackson started the game at third base. He ended up getting in some innings on the mound, as many of the Wildcats have this evening. Runner's going to take second base without a throw. Harden, he slid, he didn't have to, but pitch was right down the middle for a strike. Whippets lead it 20-1 here in the third inning. Third innings for Whippet Baseball are brought to you by Sullivan's Drugs and Gifts. That one inside corner called strike two. Jackson turned a little bit like he thought it was going to hit him. And I think he might have even looked at the umpire thinking it, try to get the call there, but that's going to bring a visit from his coach, Nicholas Morrow. Nick Morrow, that's what I've been calling him. Not to be confused with Vic Morrow, the actor. But he's going to come down and do a little coaching to his player. As Kemp walked out to speak with Ramage and then came back behind the plate. Jackson will, after the coaching from Morrow, will dig back in at home plate. Oh, and two the count. Swinging strike three, but it foul tipped it. I believe he got just a piece of it, so he ended up trying to run down to first. But it was a foul ball. So Jackson's going to have to go back and bat again. He did just get just a tiny piece of it. I got the video stream online for you today at the Boswell Media YouTube channel. That's presented by Pickles Drug Store You want to hang around for the Premier Medical post-game report. We'll have a recap and name our Autumn Ridge Dental Player of the Game. Ramage delivers to Jackson, swinging strike three, and gets away from Kemp. The run's going to come around to score, and it'll go down as a strikeout, but Jackson's able to take first base. So Triplett comes around to score. Second run of the ball game for the Wildcats. 20-2, your score. Coming to the plate will be the catcher, Caleb Hughes, grounded into the fielder's choice back in the first inning. Ramage going to throw over to first. Run Jackson back. Odin over there holding him on. Ramage looking to deal to Hughes, and he hits a little chopper. Pickle plays it, going to throw across in time to get the play. Run comes to score, and they're going to get the runner in a rundown at second. And they're going to throw, and it gets away at third base. Yeah, they got the runner in a rundown, but when they maybe threw it just a little too late while they were trying to chase him down. But run came around to score on the 5-3 put out. Let's see, that would be Harden. Came around to score. And now it's 20-3 as Nigel Anderson steps into the box. He flew out to center field. It's only over at bat in the game. Looks at strike one there. Two outs here in the top half of the third inning. An hour and 50 minutes into the ball game. Swinging strike two. Anderson chased a high fastball that was outside. Oh, and two the count. Whippetson was trying to get out of this inning. It's a little chopper to Ramage. He gloves it. He'll step and throw over to Odom at first to retire the side 1-3. But the Wildcats get two runs on one hit, one left on base. We go to the bottom of the third. Whippets lead at 20-3.
Convenient times. Central Tire Service enjoys vehicle maintenance and focuses on getting you back on the road, from brakes, alignments, and exhaust to oil changes or new and used tires for your vehicle or ATV. Central Tire Service stocks all the major brands, Kenda, Toyo, Firestone, and Goodyear. They specialize in accessories for your truck or ATV and install rough country lift kits. Central Tire Service, across from Louvel on Highway 35 in Kosciuszko.
Hey, I'm James Metters with Farm Bureau Insurance. For the past 6 years, I've been blessed to serve our community as a local insurance agent. When most people think of insurance, they think of their home and auto, which is the natural thing to do. This year, I'm shifting my focus to what's important, family. Protecting your family with life insurance is the most important insurance decision you will ever make. I'd like the opportunity to sit down with you and your family to discuss your life insurance. Together, we can build a plan that fits your needs and your budget. After all, life insurance is more than a policy. It's a promise. A promise to take care of the one.
A better tomorrow starts today with Wendy's breakfast. A tomorrow that says bay can, not bay can't. Where fresh eggs reign like opportunity. Honey butter goodness is spread, and the frosty is chinoed. At Wendy's, we don't ask what tomorrow holds, but rather, what will you hold tomorrow? Will it be the breakfast baconator or the honey butter chicken biscuit? No matter what you choose, tomorrow's looking good.
At participating U.S. Wendy's.
Hey, I'm Ryder Davis with Farm Bureau. As a young insurance agent, it hasn't taken me long to understand the value of life insurance. Even at an early age, life is unpredictable, and it is important that your life is properly insured. With age and good health, there is never a better time to get life insurance than when you're young. Whether you're married or living on your own, someone you love is responsible for you. Life is not guaranteed, but our life insurance is. Call me, text me, or come see me today at Farm Bureau on the square in Kosciuszko.
You can now bank closer to home. at Atala County Bank.
Hi, this is David Blair with Atala County Bank. I have been serving the people of Atala County with commercial, mortgage, and personal loans for 25 years. Please come see me at Atala County Bank. I look forward to serving you.
Atala County Bank, in the North Side Shopping Center next to Sullivan's in Kosciuszko. Call 290-6963. Hometown banking in your hometown. Member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender. Still serving the people of Holmes and Carroll Counties. Atala County Bank, a branch of Holmes County Bank.
Premier Medical Group and Trace Urgent Care remind you that if you have any COVID-19 symptoms, please call first. There are multiple options to see you. Also, talk to your provider about your Wellness or Healthy You appointment. This appointment is covered by most insurances, and it will help you maintain your health and prevent illnesses like cardiovascular disease and certain cancers. Premier Medical Group in Kosciuszko and Carthage, and Trace Urgent Care. Call for an appointment today.
Boswell Media Sports.
And that actually does it. While we were here during the break, they decided to call the game. I'm not sure if it was agreed upon to try to get a junior high or a JV game in before the rain. But here, yeah, that's why we had a little bit of an extended break. We thought we had to play four innings. But as I said, they looks like they made a decision to call it there about halfway through that break. So we went ahead and moved into the Premier Medical postgame report. But your final score, Kosciuszko 20. The Louisville Wildcats 3. The Whippets will move to 7-4 on the season, and 4-0 in region play. The Wildcats fall to 0-10, and then 0-5 in region play. And a really hard game to recap. The Whippets batted around in the first inning and ended up almost batting around twice because the last out was the number 8 hitter in the lineup on his second at bat in the inning. But the Whippets got 11 in the first, and then they got 9 in the second. And if I can look up here, get you the stats real quick on eight hits for the Whippets, and a number of walks and hit by pitches. So that's what it looks like. And the Wildcats only were able to bat around one time through the order, and then they got to the number 6 hitter, ended up being the final out. But 20-3 is your score, and not much we can say about the ball game. Sometimes you have games like that, and that's just what it is. Thank you for allowing me to fill in for Philip Palmertree, who's on another assignment tonight. He'll be back with you on Thursday for the return trip. These teams will be going over to playing off in Louisville this Thursday, not Friday. Friday's Good Friday, so they bumped the game up to Thursday. That way no one has to play ball on Good Friday. We'll carry that one for you here on Breezy 101. Going to be kind of cool. Well, really chilly on Thursday, so if you're going into that one over in Louisville, you might want to take a jacket. We will say thank you to Central Tire Service, Chris Coleman, Alpha Insurance, Watkins, Warden Stafford, and Angel Alvin McDonald State Farm. They would have been the inning sponsors for our innings that we did not get to, because we didn't get to them, but we wanted to make sure that we do give them, you know, their recognition for allowing us to bring you Kosciuszko Whippet baseball. So now time to name our Autumn Ridge Dental Player of the Game. Hard to name a player of the game in that one, but I was given an idea here in the press box. And if you didn't join us earlier in the ball game, Walker Hill threw out the very first pitch. He was the ceremonial first pitch. Of course, you probably know if you're a fan of Whippet baseball, you know Walker Hill's story, where he's a starter, a captain, a 3-year letter, was going to be the starting center fielder, injured in an accident back in October, unable to walk. He threw out the first pitch today. We do have that video. We'll get it cut up and get it put online for you to see. So we'll do that. But we'll also go ahead and name Walker our Autumn Ridge Dental Player of the Game. Autumn Ridge Dental, now that's something to smile about. And as I said again, thanks for allowing me to join you back in the booth for the first time since November. And it was a good good time to sit back in the chair and put on the headset. But Philip Palmetry will be back with you on Thursday. I want to say thank you to Donald back at the studio for keeping us on the air. Also, thank you to Melissa and Laura and Lisa, everyone involved in sales and production for our broadcasts. But for Boswell Media Sports, this is Breck Riley saying good night and go Whippets.